Mission Station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Catherine McLaurin. This week on Station, it's Out with the Old as the crew prepares to release the Cygnus cargo spacecraft. The Cygnus spacecraft, which arrived at the station on November 14th, will be leaving on Wednesday, December 6th. Cygnus delivered research investigations to further improve life on Earth. Now Cygnus is packed with more than 5,500 pounds of trash that will burn up as it re-enters the Earth's atmosphere. For more information and to watch live coverage of the Cygnus departure on December 6th, beginning at 7:45 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, please visit www.nasa.gov/NASA TV. In keeping with this year's theme, highlighting education on station, the crew spent time preparing the station for a high school robotics competition. Joe Acaba and Alexander Masurkin set up the Spheres work area to run a test for the Spheres Zero robotics competition that is scheduled to be performed in January 2018. Spheres Zero robotics competition establishes an opportunity for high school students to design research for the ISS. As part of a competition, students write algorithms for the Sphere satellites to accomplish tasks relevant to future space missions. The algorithms are tested by the Sphere's team, and the best designs are selected for the competition to operate the Sphere satellites on board the ISS. This week's question comes from Army Cadet Iris Yu at the U.S. Military Academy.
How did you adapt to live in space, and vice versa? How did you adapt back to life on Earth? Is there a great difficulty in doing one or the other?
I think they both have their challenges, and what's neat about coming up here is noticing how quickly the body adapts to being in space. Usually my first 24 hours, I'm on the edge of getting sick, not quite getting sick, so not feeling 100%. But once that goes away and the fluid shifting goes back to a more kind of neutral state, it's almost like we were born to be in space. And then going home, when you land, you wonder, how do humans live on this planet? Because, you know, that gravity, I don't know, you learn about gravity in physics, but it's strong after you've been up here for a few months.
For the educators out there, visit the NASA Space Place website, where NASA uses the wonders of space exploration to engage young students in STEM learning using fun apps, games, crafts, and videos. The NASA Space Place website is available in English and Spanish and has a special section just for educators. Keep sending us questions using the hashtag SpaceToGround, and we'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.